Hi everyone, NecroVMX here, welcome you to the 10 Days of Frankenstein, a 10-day event leading up to Halloween. Those of you who were subscribed last year may remember the 10 Days of Dracula feature. If not, be sure to check that out, there's a playlist for it. Anyway, this year, I'll be reviewing 10 films based on the novel Frankenstein or the modern Prometheus by Mary Shelley. Mary Shelley was only 19 years old when she wrote her tale of Science Gone Wrong, where a well-meaning college student discovers how to create life, and does so in an experiment to create the perfect human. But what he creates is a misshapen, monstrous creature. The creature kills his wife and younger brother and forces him to create a bride for it, which he does, but in his horror at what he's created, he destroys the bride. Frankenstein chases the monster all the way to the Arctic Circle, where they both meet their ends. When doing a feature reviewing movies based on the novel, or even the concept, of which there have been a lot, there's no place to start like the beginning. But while most people are more familiar with the 1931 Universal picture, there was a little-known film before that simply titled Frankenstein, and it was created and shown all the way back in 1910, making it one of the earliest motion pictures at 100 years old. And for the longest time, it was considered lost, meaning no copies of it were known to exist. It was found sometime in the early 1950s by a film collector who didn't know what he had, and it wasn't seen again until the 70s. The film is often referred to as Edison's Frankenstein, as it was created using the kinetogram technology created by Thomas Edison. Edison is sometimes credited as being the director or producer of the film, but in fact he merely owned the studio. He had nothing to do with the film's actual creation. It was released for public purchase only earlier this year, along with a novel called Edison's Frankenstein that was about the creation of the film. Now, to review the actual film, I'm going to try and keep this short, as the film in its current state is just under 13 minutes long, and I really don't want the review to be longer than the movie. The film takes certain liberties with the source material. There's no killings, and in fact, it could be interpreted that the monster never even existed and was only a representation of Frankenstein's dark side. Nobody ever sees the creature except for the young Frankenstein, and it vanishes into a mirror, which is replaced by Frankenstein's true reflection as his better nature wins out as he chooses love over his obsession with creating life by getting married. So, in a lot of ways, it could be seen as highly symbolic. However, one thing the film does get right is the vague representation of how the creature is created. In the novel, the process for creating the creature is not described explicitly, as Mary Shelley did not want anybody to try it. In the film, Frankenstein just seems to be mixing chemicals in a vat which the creature emerges from. The bride's creation in the novel was described as being similar to a golem, but that part is not in the movie, so it doesn't matter. Most films based on Frankenstein take their ideas from the Universal film and have Frankenstein use a combination of corpses and electricity to create his creatures, so in that sense, the film is pretty close to the book. The film is exceedingly short, but it gets a lot of ideas across, including the idea that the creature is a dark reflection of Frankenstein. And for 1910, the technology employed was very limited, but they did a great job with it. These days, it's more of a curiosity than anything else, and as a public domain film under 13 minutes long, the entirety of it could easily be watched on YouTube at any time. And if anything, it gives insight into the film's creation of the era. That being said, as primitive as it is, it's still rather engrossing for all 13 minutes of it, and it's not like you'd exactly lose a lot of time watching it. It's hard to rate a film like this, as modern interpretations of film are so different. But I feel that a 7 out of 10 is an appropriate way to go. It's good, and was certainly a technological marvel at the time, but it isn't much more than a showcase for that technology. And although it has a great theme, it does not explore many of the other themes from the source material. So, 7 out of a possible 10.